Good morning, everyone. Good morning, sir. So we are going to start the session. We are having with us Shri Vijay Kumar Shiv Pujay sir. I on the behalf of Sri Rampura Sarkar Institute of Pharmacy welcome you, sir. Before starting this webinar on the topic of career opportunities in intellectual property right, I would like the opportunity to introduce sir to all the participant present over here. Shri Vijay Kumar Shiv Pujay sir is the director of Petlex Business Solution, a knowledge process outsourcing firm. He is also an honorary advisor to ASSOCHAM New Delhi and mentor of change with Government of India's Niti Aayog Atal Tinkering Lab. Sir has done M.Pharm in pharmaceutics and he is also an LLB. He is a registered patent agent with Indian Patent Office and has also worked as a book reviewer for Oxford University Press Journal of Intellectual Property Law and Practice. Sir carries around 15 plus years of experience in pharmaceutical industry and law firms in the intellectual property right area. During this tenure, he served various organizations like Ranbaxy, Wockhardt and Glenmark Pharmaceuticals. As an entrepreneur with interest in innovation, law, patents, and R&D, he runs a startup named Pharma Literary, which is working actively in area of pharmaceutical education and have collaborated with various institutions and universities for skill-based activities. I think this small introduction would clearly clarify the big personality we are having today to listen. I welcome you, sir. And I'll request you to please start the presentation.
Yeah, thank you so much, Anshita ma'am. Actually, I would like to start with one golden question that we have been asking throughout the year. Am I audible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Anshita ma'am, for first of all introducing me, as well as I must thank Dr. Chanchal ma'am, for providing this opportunity and inviting for this particular session. I think I have visited the institute at Kumari twice. One, I remember that was in 2018, which was invited by the institute for the faculty development program. And the second one was kind of self-invited when we were kind of partners for conducting a program as such. So I still remember the kind of hospitality that I had at the institute. It's always a pleasure to get connected with the students as well as the faculties at the institute. So good morning to everyone, the students, the faculty members from the SRIP Kumari Institute, as well as students from other institutes. I'm going to speak on the different career opportunities for pharmacists into the area of intellectual property rights. To be honest, IPR, intellectual property rights, is a very, very broad area, and almost entire industries, all the industries or academics are involved into the intellectual property rights area. What I'm going to discuss in the career opportunities in IPR would be specifically for the pharmacy students or faculties or researchers, maybe master students, maybe a PhD research scholar, or maybe even a faculty member as well. What can you do as a patent expert or so when we speak about intellectual property rights, we have different types of IP, but then when we speak about pharmacists, and as a pharmacist, the most significant type of IP is patents. And I'm going to discuss the opportunities for students in the area of patents. This is really significant, especially I also belong to a rural area as such in Maharashtra. I'm currently sitting in a small town called Latur in Maharashtra. What is important here is, especially in the rural areas wherein probably we don't have much exposure or experience with the industries, we don't have much of the industries available. When I'm saying industries, I'm specifically speaking about the pharmaceutical industry, right? Because pharmaceutical industries are very much concentrated in very few areas, generally like what we say In Hyderabad, we have a big pharma industry. In Gujarat, in Ahmedabad, Baroda, or even in Mumbai, Pune belt, we have pharmaceutical industry. Beyond that, we have very limited number of opportunities. But then what can be done pharmacy student or a pharmacy postgraduate as such? This is one area, intellectual property rights or patents, wherein you can actually operate globally from anywhere as such. And if you are in a position to provide proper services as such, then no one is bothered actually where are you operating from. That I think that is one of the reasons I am right now here speaking in front of you, sitting in a small town, and we have so many students who have joined for the session. One more advantage of this particular industry being in patents is that what we have seen in last 10 months during this particular pandemic as such, wherein lots of businesses faced a lot of troubles. Actually, those of you who have any connects with the businesses, maybe local businesses, maybe local shops as such, everyone has faced a lot of trouble during these 8 or 10 months. One big advantage of patents is that since being in it, it's in virtual space, that is, everything is kind of online nowadays. In these times, everyone who is working in the patent domain, someone like me who is an agent or a consultant, or someone who is working in the corporate as well in the pharmaceutical industry, everyone was occupied with the work. Now, entire India was under lockdown and most of the businesses were getting hampered during this time. If you have work, that to good work, then that's a great advantage for you as such, right? And all these things are really significant when we look forward to as a career for a pharmacist, wherein we know there was a time when we had less number of graduates and more number of opportunities available. The demand and supply ratio, demand for pharmacy graduates was really huge, but the supply was really less. Now, unfortunately, this particular equation has been reversed. We have a huge supply and comparatively the demand is getting lesser because there is kind of saturation or oversaturation within the industry with respect to few departments. But then it's just not about pharma. As a pharmacist, we have got this habit to work just only for the pharma. I'll tell you how you can actually work as a patent agent if you are a patent expert in other domains as well, which I am actually doing on my own with respect to non-pharma clients as well. Now, so when we speak about patents, it's just not about pharma. It's also about the many other industries, the allied industries in life sciences sector. Like, for example, you can work directly with a FMCG company or an excipient based company or something wherever there is a research or invention happening at. In fact, across the sectors currently we are operating in. Okay. So with this brief introduction, let me go to the slides because I think slides would give you better idea what I'm going to speak and how is it actually connected to what you are learning as well. This is something really useful. One of the very questions that have been usually asked is, can we actually go into this particular domain of patents or IPR after B-Pharm? Yes, absolutely. But the general equation is that if there are two students, one is a undergraduate and the other one is a postgraduate, definitely the postgraduate would be preferred. Not because of the skill set, but there is one particular reason behind that. And the reason is that when we do undergraduate UG, B-Pharm as such, that point of time, we have less exposure or rather no exposure for research or research orientation. We understand the word research or research orientation only during masters, that point of time when we do the thesis. This is one reason that most of the times masters are preferred. M-Pharms, irrespective of the subject, may be pharmacognosy, pharmacology, chemistry, SUTEX, QA, industrial pharmacy, whatever subject is there. if you have some exposure to the research activities, that may help you to enter into this particular domain. But that doesn't rule out the possibility of a UG undergraduate. I know lots of UG students as well, but there is a difference. They started their careers maybe 10, 15 years back. Again, the same equation. That point of time, the demand for the pharmacist was very high, and the supply, those who were willing to join into patents or intellectual property rights, were very less as such, right? But now today we have lots of doctors, PhDs, even postdoc people willing to enter into the area of intellectual property rights as well. So it's always preferred to have masters, but then yes, even for a UG student, opportunities in terms of intellectual property rights. As I said, IPR is a very broad domain. What we have is patents specifically. Traditionally, when I entered pharmacy long back, around 22 years back, that point of time, what we knew was about only three fields, or rather two fields basically. If you want to have a job after BPharm, go into production, or you have two more options: do masters, go into R&D, do MBA, go into sales and marketing. Then over a period of time, we have lots of careers, upcoming careers, we know, again, these are traditional careers with the government opportunities as FDA. Recently, we have got these government hospitals also recruiting the pharmacists and all. And definitely, because of this COVID situation, definitely there is more demand of the allied industry people, like pharmacists actually, in terms of jobs. But then there is a different set of opportunities which are legal careers. When I say legal careers, it's something which is just not restricted to intellectual property rights. I'll be telling you what kind of legal careers actually you can have. Let me just go through this. Yeah. So this is a very interesting field. When I say legal careers, it's what we generally call as an approach, a lawyer, a pharmacist plus lawyer. Okay. So I did my LLB when I was working actually, in 2008 to 2011, I finished my LLB during that point of time. But so what generally happens is, as a pharmacist, you are an expert in one domain, but this time this era of the future would be for more for the interdisciplinary kind of things. So for example, what we can call as an interdisciplinary kind of thing is a biomedical engineering field, which is biology, that is even pharmacy plus engineering. Okay, so you won't be actually learning the entire engineering, but the one which is connected to pharmacy per se. Okay, or the drug delivery system kind of. So similarly, what we have is a law plus pharmacy, wherein what we have so basically all these big law firms, every area, be it pharma or any other field, is legislations or laws. And what happens is, when you have a pharmacist who has an understanding of a law, then that's a great advantage as such. Because most of the lawyers may not be in a position to understand the technical terms. When I say technical terms, let me tell you simple technical terms like a tablet, capsule, syrup, solution, emulsion, suspension, right? All these are, as a pharmacist, you know what is the difference between a syrup and a solution. That's what we are learning throughout your RB farm. But if you try to tell these things to a lawyer, as such, he may not be in a position to understand. Or for those who have done their masters, for them, a term like a difference between a sustained release dosage forms and a delayed release dosage form, right? Now, all these terminologies may be a bit difficult for a typical lawyer, but you are a pharmacist, and if you have fair amount of idea of law, it is not necessary all the laws. Like, I know patent law very well now. Okay, we have other laws which are also really helpful, like competition law here. Then we have lots of job opportunities in forensic pharmacy as well, like, you know, forensic basically. So what we study in jurisprudence, the different aspects, okay, different laws. Every law opens you new job opportunities if you are an expert in that particular law. Okay, this is pretty much possible sitting in Kumari, Raipur, or maybe even my location, Latur. One big advantage as such, as a external, like, you know, as a someone who is unbiased about the location as such, the state or the location, Raipur or Kumari, it's like, I'll tell you, you have got a big national law university right there, actually. And this is a great advantage for those who are interested in careers of pharmacy plus law. Both the things are very easily accessible. Let me tell you, we don't have a institute like this right here where I'm sitting, like, you know, the big institute like HNLU or the National Law University. But then if you are looking for these kind of careers, and there is one big advantage for these kind of careers, and that advantage, as I mentioned, is sitting in Latur. Now I know patent law, I'm a pharmacist, I have clients all across the globe. As in, I work with someone sitting in Europe, I work with someone sitting in US, I work with someone sitting in Dubai, maybe Delhi, maybe, like, you know, any part of India as such, right? This is a great advantage as far as career is concerned as such, right? So out of all these, one interesting career is a patent, related to patent law, basically. And that is what we call as a intellectual property rights. Basically, IPR is something which is for your creativity or the new things that you are creating, maybe through your master's thesis or a research project that you are doing at the UG level even. If you are protecting something, if you are doing any research, so any research-based industry, be it automobile industry, be it the IT industry, be it the FMCG industry, all these industries require a knowledge of technology and law. Reason being, for them, they need to protect their invention, legally protect their invention. So IPR basically is a combination or amalgamation of three things: technology, law, and business. Okay. When I say technology, we are expert in pharmaceutical technology. So if we have a fair amount of idea of any of the laws, then IPR may be a great career. It's a combination of both, basically, right? You know, in fact, when I started my career, plain as a technology expert, as a master's in pharmacy, at that point of time, I realized our bosses were lawyers, okay? And we were kind of reporting to lawyers. So at that point of time, I understood the field of intellectual property rights. We are recruited as a technology expert. That is absolutely fine. But later on, you can be an expert in the legal domain for that particular law. I may not be in a position to speak much on the copyright law, but I can speak on the patent law because I particular law. Not as a lawyer, but as a patent agent. I'll tell you what is patent agent as well, and how you can actually be a patent agent, and how you can actually make your career into that as well. That also I'll tell you. So basically, IPR is a legal protection for your creativity. This creativity may be invention. When we speak about invention, the right kind of intellectual property right is patent. So this is a very famous quote by US Supreme Court: anything under the sun that is made by the hand of a man is patentable if it is novel and non-obvious. मतलब दुनिया की कोई भी चीज जो human being ने बनाई है वो अगर नई है, it's a new and it's unpredictable, non-obvious, in that case definitely you can get a patent. Now you can actually explore the things. It's just not about pharma. As a pharmacist, we have got one big advantage. Let me tell you what is that advantage as such. Yes. As a pharmacist, pharmacy, this is one slide I really like to present in each of my presentations, especially when I'm speaking in front of the pharmacy students. Pharmacy has one big advantage. And that is, in your 4 years, what you are studying is almost different sciences. Now, you are learning physical pharmacy as a physics subject, physics. You have biochemistry, biology, chemistry for all 4 years, organic, inorganic, medicinal chemistry. कभी कभी बच्चों की जान ले लेते हैं ये केमिस्ट्री सब्जेक्ट्स, राइट? बट वी आर लर्निंग दैट. वी मे नॉट बी एक्सपर्ट इन बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, बट वी अंडरस्टैंड अ बेसिक कोर कॉन्सेप्ट रिलेटेड टू बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, राइट? वी लर्न इंजीनियरिंग इन फार्मास्यूटिकल इंजीनियरिंग, माइक्रोबायोलॉजी. नाउ कंपेयर दिस टू अ पर्सन हु इज अ एमएससी माइक्रोबायोलॉजी. ही मे नॉट बी इन अ पोजिशन टू अंडरस्टैंड बायोकेमिस्ट्री और बायोटेक्नोलॉजी. Or someone who is MS in biotech, he may not understand the other subject. Now, as a pharmacist, you have this big advantage. And now compare this to what I mentioned here about the different fields, anything under the sun. As a pharmacist, if you can understand the technology, like for example, we can very easily understand the technology of cosmetics, although it's a different industry. FMCG, fast moving consumer goods, like companies like HUL, Procter and Gamble, all these are based on, or a company like Lakme, these are big companies actually. There are lots of companies who are operating into the cosmetic segment. Therein, you can understand the technology very easily, right? You can understand how a cream works, how a cream is developed. But there may be a specific cosmetic science subject or a specialization in some university. But as a pharmacist, you can very easily understand this, right? Now, what you need to do is, if you know all these, you can explore these things as a pharmacist per se. And when you are doing it as a patent agent or a patent expert, basically, you have abundant opportunities all across the sectors. Generally, these are categorized into 3 or 4 sectors, basically. Typical pharma organizations as a job, companies like Dr. Reddy's Labs, Sun Pharma, Glenmark Pharmaceuticals, Lupin, Zydus, Torrent, all these companies have the requirements of they have their internal patent team or intellectual property rights team. This is a traditional way to look at the things of intellectual property rights or patent. Second opportunity, KPO's, knowledge process outsourcing industry. Now, this, of course, I'm going to discuss more on this actually in the next slide, but we have opportunities with law firms as well. And I'm pretty sure we have got good number of law firms in Jaipur, but they may not be practicing the intellectual property rights. But if they are willing to do that, definitely law firms also provide good number of opportunities. There is one advantage to be in India actually in terms of pharmaceutical industry. Global pharma file the patents in India. Every big company, Pfizer, BMS, AstraZeneca, जितने बड़े नाम हैं नॉन इंडियन कंपनीज, दे आर ऑल फाइलिंग द पेटेंट्स इन इंडिया हु आर वर्किंग विद दिस लॉ फर्म्स, बिकॉज द लॉयर्स एट टाइम्स मे नॉट अंडरस्टैंड द टेक्नोलॉजी, बट यू एज अ फार्मासिस्ट वर्किंग इन कोलैबोरेशन विद अ लॉयर कैन अंडरस्टैंड द टेक्नोलॉजी पार्ट एज वेल एज द पेटेंट पार्ट. So law firms also provide you a lot of opportunities. Then there are lots of independent practitioners. Now I'm an independent practitioner or entrepreneurs who are actually having their own firms, small firms. It may not be a big company. Generally, entrepreneurship has been considered as something, creating a big company with, let's say, a lot of space, a lot of investment and all. That's not the new age entrepreneurship concept. New age entrepreneurship concept is very simple. Efficient and can provide a job to one or two others as well, then you are kind of a successful entrepreneur. And as we have more number of, lesser number of jobs coming up, this is something which is a great opportunity upcoming as such. Now, Let me speak about, so this is another field wherein we have the law firms, the independent practitioner, wherein you can work as a patent agent, although or a patent expert or in the patent team, it's more about your technical knowledge about pharmacy. And simple questions like what is bioequivalence, what is the difference between sustained release and a delayed release formulation, all these kind of questions may be something which you would be actually discussing, or when you draft the patent, that point of time you would be actually doing. Now there are lots of KPOs, knowledge process outsourcing firms, maybe something which may not be much discussed in the pharma domain usually. KPOs, हमें BPO पता है, business process outsourcing, किसी bank से call आ गया, right? Loan लेना है क्या? Home loan, a personal loan, car loan लेना है क्या? That is a BPO kind of job. KPOs, as the name suggests, is more about the knowledge. Generally, what you would see is in BPOs, if you know good, you have good communication skills, if you know good English, then probably you are fit for that job. But in KPOs, it's about knowledge. You need to be technically competent, technical understanding ke basis pe. So let me tell you, all these big excipient companies or chemical companies always had non-pharmacists working with them. But now what is happening out is, people are exploring these options. In fact, I think recently a PhD from one of the premier most institutes in India, she joined with an excipient company. Okay, because these are providing better opportunities for the students. Of course, she didn't join into intellectual property rights, but all these companies have IPR departments as well, patent department, and you can be very easily fit because you may not be MSc chemistry or a chemical engineer, but you have studied the chemistry throughout 4 years as well, and many of you like the chemistry as well, right? And there are people who are working with these companies like BASF, companies like Colorcon, ACG, Ideal Cures, Pidilite, Aarti, Tata Chemicals, Gangwal Chemicals, and all. These are excipient companies which are actually providing the excipient. So the research is just not happening into drug discovery or the formulation. Even the research is happening into excipient companies. They are coming up with a newer excipient, newer version of the excipient at times, basically. That is something, there are opportunities for patent experts as well. Then we have, this is one area which is somewhat similar to what we do. Let me tell you, the agrochemicals or the fertilizer products have exactly the similar formulations, just like what we develop into our lab. What we study in pharmaceutical sciences, that is pharmaceutics, maybe physical pharmacy, more or less similar things, we are done into agrochemical or the fertilizer industry. The research is exactly similar. I know pharmacists working into the intellectual property rights team into Bayer, UPL, United Phosphorus Limited. It's an Indian company. Big giant like Monsanto, some local companies like PI Industries, Amco Pesti. All these companies are into research and they need IPR teams. Not only they need IPR team, at times if you cannot establish an IPR team, they would outsource the work related to IPR to individuals like me. See, a company in today's world cannot survive without having an intellectual property rights team. Because what happens is, if you are launching a product, you may not be interested to file a patent. That's absolutely fine. But if the other companies have launched the products, then what is important there is, then you need to ensure that you are not copying their products. So for that as well, you need a pharmacist to understand what is claimed there and what you are preparing as. So fertilizer or agrochemical industries, these companies also provide you a lot of opportunities as a patent agent. Then we have typical, I would say, life sciences companies like AMSA, Dabur, Himalaya, Vico, Patanjali Ayurveda, Charak Pharma, Imami, Hamdard, Badnath, Jhando. All these companies are also into allied fields, herbal products, nutraceutical, Ayurveda products, all these companies. And let me tell you, what has happened in the last 10 or 11 months is there is a huge business potential for nutraceutical products, the herbal products. Now, suddenly, what has COVID done, especially in India, is it has ensured that the significance to pharma or healthcare has been increased. People want more number of organic products, nutraceutical products. Everyone wants to go the Ayurveda way or the herbal way, basically. Right? Now, all these companies are also into research, and definitely there are opportunities as a pharmacist into intellectual property rights. Whichever industry I'm telling you, which is into research, now we have lots of instrument providers. Yeah, instruments, jo aap tableting machine dekh rahe ho, dissolution apparatus dekh rahe ho, ye kahan se aate hai? Is there any research happening into them? Yes, it's also, these are industries jahan pe, we have companies like Janssen's. I have a very close friend who works with Janssen's into typically a formulation ya baki cheezon mein, but then they are also into research, and it explores it opens up opportunities for people like you and me to work with these companies into intellectual property rights. We have companies like Acupac, CADMAC, Electrolab, jo aap just go to your lab, Sutix lab, chemistry lab, jo instrument hai wo unpe naam dekhiye, all these companies, and ask your teachers what kind of instruments they had 20 years back or 15 years back. You would come to know there's a lot of difference happening, and there is an invention or innovation happening in these industries. And as a pharmacist, definitely you know what is required as an end product in a tableting machine, right? Now, this is a combination of engineering plus pharma, but definitely pharma is required here. Okay, now the next is very unexplored, untapped area, but a lot of research happening into it. ACG capsules, Bill Care, Himalayan group of industries, pharma packaging. Now see, what I have tried to do herein is, I have tried to tell you the different avenues for you to work, not only in intellectual property rights, but generally in other areas if you are interested. Definitely, I told you about more number of opportunities in terms of intellectual property rights or patents, but all these companies, and these are allied companies basically, which are pharma industry as such, and the kind of cap that are being prepared, okay, all these, or the maybe like the packaging, actually, all these things need to be updated regularly. There is a lot of invention research happening in these domains, and definitely you need pharmacists to take care of it. Now, all these were pharma allied industries and all. Let me tell you something, more number of opportunities, because I come from a very small town, and herein we have a typical traditional kind of viewpoint that you should, aapko government ki job chahiye, be it maybe locally or central government, but aapko government job hui to bahut acha hai. And let me tell you, in last 10 or 15 years, lot of opportunities have come up in terms of government of India or even state governments as patent examiners. Now, patent examiners are technical experts only. They are not, never a lawyer is a patent examiner. Jitne bhi hai, we have MBBS doctors, we have engineers, we have people from biomedical engineering, we have people from pharmacy, we have people from biotechnology. But let me tell you, very few people from pharmacy. Okay? But all these are patent examiners. These are government, actually. And I think in 2017 or 16, government came up with 200 plus openings, actually, at one point of time. एंड दीज थिंग्स आर लाइक परकोलेटेड टू अ लेवल जहां पे अपने रूरल एरियाज के स्टूडेंट्स कैन कम टू नो एंड पार्टिसिपेट इन टू इट एज वेल. ओके, वी हैव अ बिग इंस्टीट्यूट बाय CSIR इन पुणे विच इज कॉल्ड यूरोडिप. जस्ट गूगल आउट, यूरोडिप हैज लॉट्स ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटीज. CSIR has, like, you know, of course, these are project assistant kind of opportunities as well for pharmacists even, I'm telling you, okay? Jahan pe, you can work as a expert, technical expert. Again, see, whatever opportunities I told you, aapki pharmacy ki knowledge bahut zaruri hai wahan. The same happens with your department. That one program specifically for females, I would like to mention here is Government of India trains almost 200. Let me repeat you, 200 females every year who had a career break because of XYZ reasons. If you have a career break, Government of India provides you an option to be trained for 1 year. So Government of India, TIFAC, conducts this Kiran IPR program under which 200 females every year are trained along with some fellowship, anywhere between 20 to 35,000. There is an age limit, so, like, you know, you cannot participate below 27, I believe. I don't know exact numbers. But then if you have a career gap break, okay, maybe because of family or other reasons, then you can go for this program. Just 1 month of training in Delhi and 11 months, you are already paid for 12 months. And, like, you know, thereafter, you can work in the intellectual property rights department at different locations accordingly. Now, next thing is IPR cell establishment. Now, what I see here is that when I'm speaking at a institute which is located in Kumari, Raipur, in the state of Chhattisgarh, we have got penetration of intellectual property rights, patents everywhere all across India. All your agencies like MHRD, AICT, UGC, not PCI Abhitak, but then all these other agencies want you to establish. If you're going for NAC, if you're going for NBA accreditations, definitely what you need is some kind of IPR setup established at your institute, IPR cell establishment. Now, simple question is, how many number of institutes or universities we have, and how many of them have actually got IPR cell established? Very few, right? There is a tremendous scope moving ahead. Of course, IPR cell, when we establish, let's say, at an institute like ours, it may not be the only task about IP generation or filing, but initially you may be involved into lots of other activities like teaching and all. But IPR cell establishment is definitely helping the institutes in terms of their NAC grading, NBA grading, or NIRF ranking as well. We have this opportunity to work with lots of IPR cells or established IPR cells, even at few pharmacy colleges and non-pharma colleges and universities as well. We've been involved into that as well as, like, you know, so all these are creating bigger number of opportunities not only pharmacy students, but allied fields as well, like, you know. So that is something which is really crucial. IPR for home, basically. If you are moving abroad for your MS, MBA, PhD, definitely IP is going to help. Research careers, yes. If you want to learn IP, of course, IP itself is an opportunity, career opportunity. But if you are looking forward for a career into typical formulations or drug discovery, yes, the knowledge of IP is really significant. If you are into academia, let me tell you, we have filed almost 120 plus applications, and out of that, almost, I would say, 90 to 100 are from academics, educational institutions. If you want to be working in a strategy or a business professional, therein also you have opportunities actually for working or, like, you know, for having the knowledge of intellectual property rights. So actually, I have kind of done with my slides or telling you all about activities we are involved into as an organization. But before that, I would like to take questions, if at all there are any.
Thank you, sir. It was really a very nice presentation regarding IPR and career opportunities in IPR. We are having some of the questions. I request everyone to please drop their question in the chat box. And Asa ma'am, over to you.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, students, if you have any question, you can ask. Sir, I want to ask one thing, sir. Can bioactives, if you use any bioactives and if you formulate any using any formula, but that can be patented or not?
Yes, ma'am, it can be done. We have been doing the similar thing. Yes, absolutely.
Okay, sir. Any more questions?
One of the question that has came from one of our MPharm students, she want to know what are the special duty of a patent attorney or a patent agent.
Okay, let me brief you about the patent agent and the concept of patent attorney as well. Basically, in patent office, lawyers are not allowed to practice for all the activities. People like you and me, pharmacists, engineers, all these are allowed after clearing an exam. And if you are a B-Pharm graduate, you are allowed to appear for the exam. All these exam details is conducted by Government of India. Just like you have this pharmacist certification, after completing B-Pharm, we have this patent agent as a recognition. It comes with a number actually. Patent agent number. All these things are done through Government of India. Every year the exam is conducted. Any student, let me tell you, who has a UG degree. So there are lots of master's students from Nagpur, Mumbai are actually I know them. While doing their master's of pharmacy, they are appearing for the patent agent examination as well. Okay, that opens up opportunities for you a lot. Now, patent attorney is a patent agent plus lawyer. So like I did my law, I mentioned. Okay. So attorney is different from agent. Attorneys can practice in court as well. See, patent agent cannot practice in court. They can practice only in patent office with respect to filing, prosecution, and jo bhi patent applications at the patent office. And these are good career opportunities. Yeah.
So she is also asking that whether it is necessary to have a law degree to become a patent agent, or after having a internship we can become a patent agent.
So patent agent, as I said, is an exam actually which is conducted. There is no internship that is required for that. You can directly be a patent agent. And law is something which is basically optional. It's not mandatory. If you can do. But most of the times, what I have seen is someone like me who is practicing or who is working in the industry, along with that, they are doing LLB as an additional degree as well. But definitely, it's not mandatory. It's not necessary. But then if you have it, then kind of you may have some advantage. That's the thing.
So anyone else who want to ask us questions, they may drop in the chat box.
Yeah, what I'll do is I'll take you through my other slides, which two or three slides I have, what activities we are doing, with whom we are associated. We are almost associated with every college in Mumbai, Bombay College of Pharmacy, KM Kundnani, Bhanuben Nanavati. So like almost 11 colleges in Mumbai. Outside also, we have collaborated with lots of colleges for coming up for, we have signed the MOU, even we recently signed MOU with UR Engineering as well, for conducting training programs as well as filing patents as well as helping them to NAC, NBA, NIRF rankings as well. Some of these institutes are among the top 3 or 25 in the NIRF ranking all across India as well. As well as we have this brand called Pharma Literate. If you can see the logo at the bottom, Pharma Literate works specially for the UG students. There are lots of you can go through the YouTube channel of the this particular name Pharma Literate as well, which has lots of videos which are which would be really relevant for the students as such in different kind of careers like entrepreneurship, like something like regulatory affairs or pharmacovigilance. There are lots of videos there by the industry. Pharma Literacy is a venture wherein lots of industry experts are associated with us to train and bridge that gap between academy and actually the industry. As an organization, of course, Pharma Literacy is one of the ventures of Patlex Business Solutions. We are working with the biggest pharma company in India. Now, I can't tell the name, but everyone knows what is that, which is the biggest pharma company in India. We are also working with a European generic company as well as a research-based company, which is among top 10 in India, working with lots of startups, MSMEs, and industry association like Sucham as well. And over a period of time, it's just, as I said, it's just not about India as such, but outside India as well, we have got client base where with whom we are operating or working with respect to different activities as such. Pharma, non-pharma, we are working with a telecom company, telecom industry, jo hum mobile handsets and all ki baat karte hain, unke saath kaam kar rahe. We are working with a civil contractor as well. Jo technology aapko samajh mein aaye, that can be something which would be really helpful as such. So that's what I have as far as my organization is
concerned. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Now I request Alok sir, over to you, sir, for a vote of thanks.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Good afternoon, everyone. I am Dr. Alok Singh Thakur. I want to convey my thanks on behalf of Sri Rawatpura Sarkar Institute of Kumhari. We are very privileged that we have with us Sri Vijay Kumar Shivpuja sir, Director Patlex Business Solution and advisor to SOCHEM New Delhi, and also the mentor of change with Government of India's Niti Aayog Atal Tinkering Lab. Sri Vijay Kumar Shivpuja sir has given his lecture to explain about the career opportunities in intellectual property rights. It was very convincing and easy to understand, and I want to thank to sir for making this joint topic to very convenient to understand, and it will be very helpful for our student and audience to apply for the intellectual property rights and also understand the what kind of things we can do in research to get the authorization. Thank you, sir. I also want to thank to Dr. Anshita Gupta Soni ma'am for conducting this webinar, and I want to convey my gratitude towards the principal and professor Dr. Chanchaldeep Kaur ma'am and our director Mr. M.K. Srivastava sir for providing us the platform of WeTalk webinar. We are very privileged and thankful for having such a kind of students and participants who are patiently listening and understanding and supporting us to conduct such kind of webinar continuously. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Alok sir, for the vote of thanks. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Shivpuja sir, for taking time for us from your busy schedule and giving such a good presentation. I hope the student must be very heated because many of the students are now interested in patents and research and they need to file. And I just want to share one thing that many of the students we are having in NCERN, they are very eager to know about patents and they want to do some work with keeping a patented and fruitful for their future. So, thank you so much, sir. I hope this presentation of yours will be totally very much benefited for them. Thank you so much.